Hello everyone, this is Gurveen here. In this video today, we will have a look at some of the attributes and the sub-elements of one of the most commonly used XML actions, which is entity find in Mocky. So we have seen a brief introduction of what this operation does, and also we have had a look at how it can be used in the services and the syntax of it in the previous sessions of service attributes. So just a quick recap. In the documentation under logic and services, we have overview of XML actions. So what entity find does is it finds the records for the entity name mentioned in the entity name attribute, and then it puts that entity list object in the list attribute. Now there are other attributes like cache, distinct, offset, and limit. And then we also have other sub-elements which can be used for putting the conditions for the entity find operation. So in this video today, we will have a look at how we can use entity find for a particular use case. And the use case being that we want the entity find to be performed only when there is some parameter or a condition passed to it. So it should not return all the records of the entity if there is no condition matching, but instead it should return an empty list. So how we can achieve that is, so there is one of the out of the box examples available in the asset screen. So if we have a look at the simple screens component, and under the asset directory, we have the find asset screen. So we have the entity find definition here under the form list for listing assets. So we can see the use of the search form inputs and the require parameters attribute. So let us have a look what this actually does is. So the search form inputs, it adds the conditions for the fields which are found in the input fields map. So input fields map is another attribute of this element. So this is the map where we can get the form fields from. And if this is empty, then it is looked at the web parameters map if the web facade is available. Otherwise, it will take it or check it from the current context. So this search form inputs also supports special fields, like if we want to use the suffixes for operators or the ignore case. So what it will does is it will process the data from the various inputs which is generated by the XML form. And for people who have experience of working in Apache OFS, so there is a reference mentioned that this is basically what the prepare find service does in OFS. So if we go back at the example, so this is a form which is listing the assets, and we have some of the fields available like asset ID, product ID. So whatever input is given, on the basis of that data, it will find the records for this entity, view entity. And since the required parameters is set to true, it will only perform this operation when one of the fields is receiving some data from the form. So to see this in action, let us have a look at the Mocky UI. So if we go inside the POPC ERP and under the assets, we have asset summary, and then we have find individual assets. So this is exactly the place where that find asset screen is being used. So we can see that it is not listing the records when we have come to this screen, the path till find asset, since the required parameters is set to true. So if we change this to false and see its effect. Now if I refresh the screen, we can see that it is listing all the records for that view entity. Since we changed the setting of required parameters to false, now the query became like a simple select star from the asset find view. So using the search form inputs and the required parameters attribute, we can achieve the behavior where it will perform the entity find only when some of the a condition or parameter is passed to the entity find. Now this is in the context of a screen, like when the entity find is used with a form list. So we can also use this in a service which is written for a REST API, and which we will have a look at in the next video, and we will see how input fields map can also be used for putting the conditions other than equals operator as well. Thank you.